So the first process, the first phase of the treatment is evaluation, making sure that the patient is eligible to receive high doses of chemotherapy and stem cell transplantation. Once the patient is eligible, deemed eligible to receive this aggressive form of treatment, then the next step is to make sure that patient undergoes a catheter placement, which is usually a big line that is placed in the major vessel of the chest, which is close to the heart. And then the process of stem cell mobilization begins, which involves administration of a granulocyte colony stimulating factor, which is a cytokine which is used to stimulate stem cells which are present in the bone marrow. The stimulation of stem cells in the bone marrow leads to moving the stem cells from the bone marrow into the peripheral blood. The patients then undergo leukapheresis or harvesting of the stem cells, which is done usually in the clinic, done over 1 to 3 days through a line which is placed in the chest. And a usual dose of stem cells that is required is about 2.5 to 5 million stem cells per kilogram. And once the stem cells are harvested, they are frozen in the blood bank, placed in a liquid nitrogen, and kept viable and alive for about 10 years after harvesting of stem cells is done. Following this phase of treatment, patients receive high doses of chemotherapy, and stem cells are given back to the patient, which are in the freezer of the blood bank, about 24 to 48 hours after completion of chemotherapy. The third phase of treatment is the period of myeloablation or bone marrow suppression and the side effects from chemotherapy, which can last from anywhere from 7 to 10 to 14 days. The stem cells start to regenerate and produce new cells, and this is called engraftment phase, and that is when patients start to feel better. The discharge from the program is usually 1 to 3 weeks after stem cells have engrafted and the blood counts have returned to normal.
This excerpt is brought to you by the Massachusetts School of Law, the leader of reform in legal education and a leader in multimedia education for the public. To view the full interview and for a full listing of MSL's programs, log on to mslaw.edu.